Today we have with us Dr. Mahesh Gupta, President of PhD Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Since PhD Chamber mainly represents MSME sector, we would try to understand from him the challenges that this sector is facing and his expectations from Finance Minister Arun Jaitley in upcoming budget 2016. Sir, welcome to our show.
Namaskar.
So the first question that I would like to ask is that PhD Chamber, as we all know, represents mainly micro, small and medium enterprises. So what challenges this sector is primarily facing as of now? What challenges, according to you, this sector is facing, and what is your expectations from Finance Minister Arun Jaitley in upcoming budget 2016?
Let's see the problem of MSME industries right now. The whole world is going through a slowdown process, a recession which is very, very severe. We have seen the crude oil prices come down from $110 to about $25. This reduction in price is not because of excessive production in the market, but it's because of reduced demand. Each country is facing reduction in demand. Now, once the demand gets reduced and the slowdown happens in the economy, everybody gets affected. The large industries are affected, no doubt about it. Steel manufacturers are affected. But most affected people at this moment is MSME. Because MSME gets its orders from the big industries. The moment the bigger industries are not performing well, the smaller ones gets the biggest problems in them. They are not having orders, A. B, in India, their cost of borrowing is very high. They have to borrow at about 12%. Because if they don't have money, where else they go? They are in losses. And to make up that losses, they have to borrow more. And banks are not in a position to give them more funding. Simultaneously, their friends are not able to give them funding. And on top of it, a new company law has come in. That company law prohibits funding from their sister companies. Now, they are really crushed. MSME is in a very bad shape right now because of this slowdown.
Can you please explain what is the state of health of MSME sector? Can you just elaborate? You said it is in very bad health.
It's because, I said it's bad health because A, their demand is reduced. They don't are running at a full capacity. They cannot reduce their labor. They have to continue to do overhead. And then financially, the funds are not available to them. There is a total crunch of funds with them. So they are in a bad shape from all the angles.
Sir, what are your expectations from Finance Minister Arun Jaitley in upcoming budget 2016?
Mr. Jaitley has spelled out his expectations from the budget. He said in the Saturday meeting to the public that don't expect a populist budget. He wants to concentrate on building up a good structural balance in the budget. So I think we are not going to get very, very much reliefs in the budget. But I do expect one thing very surely, which our chamber has also explained to the pre-budget meetings, that we want this budget to be demand generation oriented budget. The real problem in the industry today is there is no demand. If by some processes this demand can be generated in the industry, this will help to boost up the sentiment and it will revive the economic activity in the budget. We don't want to say, okay, reduce this tax, reduce this tax, reduce this tax. But we certainly would like the people of India to come back to the market and start purchasing.
No, just to generate the demand is a very broad term. What specific steps do you expect from the government? You must have something in mind to say.
Yeah, we had in mind and we have spelled out to the government. I'll give you one simple step on the process. Housing sector and the real estate sector is one sector which gives the maximum jobs to the people. And housing is required by each and every individual. When the interest rates were 6%, I think everybody was running around and trying to buy a house. Why? Because instead of giving a rent, they could buy a house of their own and live in that house. But today, with 12% interest or 11% interest, the housing EMI is so high, a consumer is not able to devote. Now, government cannot reduce interest rate because if they reduce interest rate, they will be reduced for all sectors. Therefore, we suggested to the government that to boost the housing sector, let us increase the exemption limit on interest loan from 2 lakh rupees to 5 lakh rupees. If government will do this activity, they will be able to reduce EMI on an individual to a greater extent. A. The government will certainly will have lesser collection on income tax because of this exemption. But government will benefit indirectly in terms of more excise duty and more service tax. So net effect, government will not lose anything, but this will revive the whole of the housing sector. And once the housing sector gets revived, the jobs comes into the market. Once jobs come into the market, the excise duty, there is more of cement production, there is more of steel production. The whole economic activity gets revived. So we would like similar steps to come into the economic activities so that people start buying.
So housing is one sector, but you know, under MSME, there are so many sectors. So what are, if I may ask you, what are the five top suggestions that you have given to Finance Minister Jaitley, and you are expecting them to be implemented in this budget?
See, what we have said is the loan to the MSME sector should become more easy. At the moment, loan is given by banks by mortgaging the property. No MSME sector gets a loan unless he mortgages his property. Now, this is sahukari. It is not based on the project. How viable is the project and how effective is an entrepreneur? We would like, if that condition is not there in an organized sector, why should this condition be there in a small scale sector? A. B. MSME sector is the least defaulter compared to the bigger sectors. So why should MSME be punished all the time? So we would like MSME to have funds very easily accessible. Number two, we would like government to bring in MSME into the defense sector purchase. A new purchase policy, offset policy is coming up. In that policy, we like MSME to be reserved certain amount of percentage of production, because worldwide is the MSME sector which has contributed to the defense sector. Similarly, we would like the public sector units or bigger units to purchase a larger share of their purchases from the MSME sector. They should be given a boost so that they can develop products for the larger industries and supply to them. Number fourth, we would like whatever is the research and development happening into the CSIR laboratories, those research should be made available to MSME sector. They should be offered in terms of project terms. Yes, you can come and produce this, and this is required by the country. So if this technical offer can come to MSME sectors, the MSME sector will certainly get revived.
Any specific expectation on tax regime, corporate tax?
Well, we have a lot of expectations, and if government should support, we have said that the government has decided to reduce corporate tax up to 25% by taking out a lot of deductions, and that should be very clearly well defined, what all deductions will get out and how the corporate tax will come out. But first and foremost thing is, let's reduce the surcharge. There is no need to have a surcharge on the income tax. So from the corporate taxation angle, they should remove the surcharge at least.
And do you believe that the finance minister is going to fulfill these expectations? You must have interacted with him.
Well, I think he has said 25% tax would come in 3 years' time. So, and it is in the phased manner. So from 30%, or in fact, I should say 33%, including surcharge, it has to come down to 25 in 3 years' time. So at least 3% should happen every year by that logic.
What is your reading of the performance of Indian economy? Because, you know, the exports are declining, the manufacturing sector is underperforming, and then there is a lot of activity that was expected in private investment that is also not coming. So under these circumstances, what is your reading of the health of Indian economy?
Well, whatever three areas you have said we are not performing, they are correct. We have a reduced exports, we have a reduced investment from the manufacturing sector. But simultaneously, we must understand that Indian economy is still growing at 7.5%. Our economy is in a very robust.
I will come to that. There is a viewpoint that that's primarily because of the new GDP series that the government has introduced. And recently, even the RBI governor said that we need to be very cautious in measuring our GDP. Well, that's a separate part. Let's come to these three sectors.
Okay,
the
right.
Exports, manufacturing and private investment. All these three are under stress.
They are under stress for what? Let's understand. Is it because of the bad health of the Indian economy, or is it a worldwide phenomenon? Today, the whole world has become one family. You cannot see yourself insulated from the world. If something happens in China, it affects us. Something happens in Europe, it affects us. Today, the exports are down not because India cannot export. It's down because there is no demand in the world market. So every country is suffering because the oil prices have come down so immensely that in the Middle East, people have no buying power. The Europe is still struggling against their bad debts. The China economy is coming down. So under such severe situation, it is very difficult for the Indian exporter to go and find a market. A. B. Manufacturing is down because there is no demand. If exports are down, so is the Indian demand has come down. So the manufacturing is down. Investment is not coming forward, because if manufacturing is not happening, how can Indian investor go and invest into the funds? Because today the problem is not of growing, problem is of sustainability. When we are not able to sustain ourselves to meet the salary requirement of people, how do you expect industry to go and borrow funds and then invest into something? So these are the problem interrelated, and these are temporary phenomena. But if you see on a macro scope, the Indian rupee has performed better. let's forget about GDP numbers, let's forget about Indian rupee. Indian rupee has been the best performer compared to the other economies of the developing countries. When we were talking of BRIC development, where is the Brazil and where is Russia? Both are gone. And China is coming down. So you have to oversee our economy in terms of the total world scenario at the moment. We are suffering, but we are less suffering. I'll put it like
that. Are you suggesting that we cannot do anything, we will sit idle, we cannot take any proactive steps, that we are totally entirely dependent on global economy, and that we don't have to even bother that our exports are declining, manufacturing is underperforming, private investment is not happening?
No, I am not saying so. We have to first.
Should we wait for the global economy to recover?
No. Let's understand. I did not say that. I said why it is happening. I answered that. What we need to do now.
Right.
So what we need to do right now is again to revive demands. I'll put it in a different way, which you will understand. When should I build my home? Suppose, and when should I buy? If you are an individual consumer, when should you buy a house? When it is the cheapest, right? And when should you invest? When it is the cheapest. So as far as if you look at from the systems approach, in India, you should build homes when? When steel is at the lowest price in the world market. When oil is at the lowest prices. When cement is at the lowest prices, which is the case right now. So this is the most ideal time for the government to revive economy so that we can buy at the lowest price in the world market today and build facilities at this time. If I have to build roads, I must build them today. I borrow funds from overseas, I bring in FDIs, I borrow it on credit, build it up today and pay them later. That is the best thing. Suppose the oil goes to $110 after 3 years, that would be a very bad time to build your infrastructure. So building
in. Why is it not happening?
Why it is not happening? That's what we have requested government to push up the demand and push up the investment. And if the government will push up investments in the public sector, the investment in private sector will get boosted automatically.
You are saying at this juncture, the key to growth is public investment. Is that what you are suggesting?
I am suggesting the public investment be growth oriented, the demand oriented budgets, the demand oriented activities from the government side.
So it's not that finance minister does not understand all this. So when you met him, what were his reactions?
Well, it was not a two-way process. It was a one-way process. He listened to us and obviously kept his decision to himself.
Let me come back to that GDP question. You know, there's a lot of skepticism, speculation over the new GDP series that the government has introduced. Now, what has happened that even the RBI governor has now said that we should be more cautious about measuring our GDP because the number 7.4% growth, it does not match other parameters like the factory output and then the bank loan and corporate profitability. So there is some gap. What is your reading of the new GDP series that the government
has introduced? Understand, where does the government GDP comes in? It basically comes in from three sectors. It comes in from the agriculture sector, it comes in from manufacturing, and it comes in from servicing sector. Why GDP of India is growing? India's the manufacturing is down, agriculture is not growing, so our GDP is growing because of service sector. Let's understand this point. The Indian services to worldwide and Indian services amongst ourselves are growing. Initially, services were never counted. Servicing, counting and GDP happened few years back. And more services are being taxed today. So more and more services are getting recorded into services. Suppose I used to get something repaired from across the street from a vendor. That vendor was never getting registered as his output. But today, since he is registered in service tax, even his activities are being getting registered into the economic activity. So that is how the GDP number is growing.
So let me come to the GST bill. How important is GST bill for the MSME sector? How essential is or how good is for this sector?
See, I tell GST. You, it's most important for MSME sector. See,
how does it affect?
I tell you how it is most important. See, today, suppose you are a large company, you can get yourself registered in different states for sale tax. And then you can ship your goods on 0% stock transfer. And then you can sell in that state. So big companies are not really benefiting from GST. Big companies will have the same transaction happening. In fact, if you ask, let's say, my company, which is present in all states, I will not waive off my sale tax registration in each state because I must make my goods available at the point of sale. I can't be selling from Noida and expecting in Chennai I'll be able to ship every time in Chennai. I'll have to take sale tax registration in Chennai. So my process of sales would remain the same. Whereas it is very, very important for MSME sector to sell their goods all over India. Today they are not able to sell their goods all over India because they can't take registration into all states. And every small consumer does not have a CST registration that he can buy, he can sell on CST. So to my mind, GST would be most effective to MSME industries who will find their market expanding immediately overnight that they can sell all over the country.
So how do you look at the parliamentary logjam because of which this particular bill has got stuck in the parliament? What is your perspective on that?
It's a very unfortunate that bit of a politics is being played, and the bill which is of most important revolutionary reform in the country is not getting through. Well, I think Wowser Council should prevail over all opposition parties. They should get united. Corporate India wants it. All governments want it. It's only little bit of flaws in the acts which they should sit down and resolve which are the best. And I think there are three differences which the government is facing from the main opposition party. And out of that, one has already been reconciled, that government is ready to forego interstate sale tax, which their CST they were proposing. And the balance two are very minor things which they should sit down or a cup of tea and have more frequent cup of tea and resolve it.
Sir, now coming to this MSME sector, there are certain paid projects of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, like he talks about Make in India, he talks about Skill India, then Digital India, Startup India. In all these projects, the MSME sector is going to play a very vital role. First of all, I would like to understand that as the concept, how do you find these projects of Prime Minister Modi and what needs to be done to actually implement it on the grassroots level?
I think this is a wonderful initiative which he has undertaken. Everybody knew MSME has to grow, but instead of saying MSME only to grow, he is asking Skilling India to grow, let's say, Digital India to grow, Manufacturing in India to grow. Because these are the steps, once they will grow, the whole economy will grow. And people will find employment in this. If you skill the people, they'll find employment not only in India, they'll find employment in the worldwide sector. If you manufacture in India, then manufacturing will grow. Because they know unless manufacturing grows to 25% of GDP, the real employment in the industry would not come through. And that growth will have to come through the MSME industries. Only then employment will happen. So all these initiatives are a great initiative. They make people dedicated to these initiatives and they remember that we need to do this. So we support them very well.
Coming to Make in India, it seems very promising, but what are the challenges that you as an entrepreneur face, and what challenges this project will face in India, given the fact that we have red tape and so many hurdles? So what hurdles that the government needs to look into
The Make in India is a concept wherein we are inviting the foreign companies as well as Indian entrepreneurs to start manufacturing in India. There was a real problem of establishing a manufacturing unit in the country. I think with ease of doing business as an initiative by the Honorable Prime Minister of India, a lot of changes have come into registration processes and starting a unit. Those units, those procedures are helping companies to establish their shops here in India. And they're thinking of doing more investment in the country. But it's a process which will take a little bit of a time. The manufacturing cannot start overnight. Services can start easily, but manufacturing will take a bit of a time for investment. Unfortunately, with these initiatives came this slowdown. So this has a little bit dampened the atmosphere. But I'm sure this is not going to last for a long time. This phase is getting over slowly, and manufacturing in India will get a big boost.
Do you have any specific suggestion to the Prime Minister on this Make in India? The areas which are perhaps being ignored or have been left out that the government needs to pay more attention?
I think the more an area which should be looked into very importantly is innovation. What India is lacking is research and development and innovation in their new technologies and new products. And we have so many laboratories, CSI laboratories, where so much research is happening. Those research should be made available to the country. Government should promote more of research and innovations into the country, because if we have to excel, we have to excel in terms of offering right solution to the consumers. We don't have to excel in terms of making a low grade solutions. We want to be a quality manufacturer into the country. So if more research is done, more innovation is emphasized, then I think we'll improve our offer to the world market.
So one project that I would like to specifically mention is the Startup India, perhaps to encourage entrepreneurship among the Indian youth. Yourself is a very successful entrepreneur. So what advice would you give to the young generation, those who want to get into entrepreneurship, and what steps the government should take to make things easy for the startups and young entrepreneurs?
See, first let's look at the entrepreneurship. See, when I started as an entrepreneur in the year 1985, things were very, very difficult. But today things are opened out, and we must look at the Indian population of 1.3 billion connected by internet is looking at many, many possibilities. They all want to grow very fast. The whole market is going to become very big market. Now, to meet this demand in big market, the young entrepreneurs must think that is the right opportunity to come in and set up their manufacturing in India. And this is the right time to be an entrepreneur, whether you want to be manufacturer or you want to be servicing expert. And this is the right time to come in. And they are also at a great advantage that they are coming at a time when there's a slowdown. Because you can get everything on bargain at this time. If the things will be doing very well in the market, it will be very difficult to find a space, let's say if you want to market a product into a newspaper. It will be very difficult to find a plot where you want to manufacture once things are going very well. This is the right time when things are a bit slow down. You can set up your manufacturing, you can set up your concept, you can set up your ideas and experiment. So this is an ideal time when there's a slowdown for people to come and have entrepreneurship. People must believe that Indian growth story is going to be there, and demand would be there, and it's a right opportunity for them to come in. But simultaneously, they must understand that entrepreneurship is a risky business.
So this Chinese slowdown, there is a view in India that it offers enormous opportunity to the Indian industry. Even the MSME minister, Karaj Mishra, said a few time back that this is an opportunity for the Indian industry. My question is the Indian industry ready to grab this opportunity coming out of Chinese slowdown?
Well, to my mind, the Chinese slowdown is not such a big slowdown. They have created huge manufacturing facilities. At the moment, demand is not there. But we are not really competing with China to that extent. That MSME sector in India will go because Chinese. People who are buying from China will come back to India and start buying from it. But we should have facilities to offer those type of opportunities. We don't have those manufacturing facilities what China has got today. So we need to create those facilities first, and then say we can benefit from it.
So you're saying that this Chinese slowdown is not going to help Indian economy much?
Well, it is going to help Indian economy in the sense that people will look at India.
In attracting investments.
Attracting investment. But not what they have already created. See, if you look at the China, look at their roads, look at their infrastructure, look at their power utilities, look at their factory size, they're too huge, too many facilities have been created there. So they will always have an extra advantage of pricing compared to the Indian manufacturing.
If I may ask you, what is the secret behind your success and what is your message to the young entrepreneurs of India?
Well, my secret to success is only one, that whatever products I have brought out are all innovative. They're first time in the world. And I give a lot of emphasis on research and development. And I would like people to come out with solutions which are unique and which offer value to a consumer. And if you do that, whatever situation you are, you'll be one up. And my advice to young entrepreneurs is again the same thing. Please offer innovative solutions, please offer value to the product. That's what business is all about. Business is what? Giving less, taking more. It's not like love, giving more, taking less. When I studied RO purifiers first time in 1999, I was selling at 20,000 rupees against a normal, well-established brand of about 3,500. My prices were 7 times. I struggled for 4 years to sell my product. And it was very difficult to establish. Many times I thought I should wind up this process and get into some other product which I was already doing it. But my inner voice told me, it's a better solution. A, B, whosoever was using it was praising the product. So that consolation convinced me that there's a future for this market because people require a better solution. So my advice to young entrepreneurs is you must have belief in what you see. And it will take some time to fructify. If you put some seeds into the soil, it's not going to become a tree overnight and you won't get a fruits overnight. You have to let it grow, and after growth, you will certainly get fruit. Thank you.